Welcome back to Summit Racing Quick Flicks. Today we're going to go ahead and start a four-part series on selecting the right cylinder heads. Today in part one of this series, we're going to talk about runner size. You're going to notice that when you go ahead and select a set of heads for your engine, you're going to have a lot of options when it comes to runner size and sometimes shape also. A lot of us get in trouble because, much like when we go to select the camshaft, we have a vision of bigger being better. And with cylinder heads especially, that is not the case. Depending on how the vehicle is going to be used, how much compression the engine has, cubic inch displacement, all these factor into the size of runner that's going to work most effectively and efficiently on your engine combination. In most cases, our goal is with the runner size, especially on the intake side, is that we want to keep air speed up. We don't want to just be able to go ahead and take in a lot of air, but we got to make sure that air is able to move at an efficient rate. And one thing you'll notice is, especially if you've been paying attention to like pro stock over the past 20 or 30 years or so, they've gone from ports that are this big down to this size, because it's more about efficiency than it is about volume for all engine combinations for the most part. Therefore, it's very important to understand how those runner sizes relate to your engine combination. Now, when it comes time to select a set of heads for your application, every application is going to be uniquely different from the next. Today, we're just going to kind of focus on the small block Chevy applications and talk about some general things that we're going to look at when it comes to selecting a head for a small block Chevy. And you can kind of carry those over to your application in a sense, even though they may not relate to one another equally. For a small block Chevy that had a lower compression ratio, somewhere around 9.5 to 1, let's say, lower cubic inch displacement, somewhere in the 350 range or so, we probably want to go ahead and stay with a smaller runner head, something in the 175 cc range, 180 cc range, to keep that air speed up. Because what you'll notice is if you lack for cubic inch displacement as well as compression, what you'll have is you have a situation to where the head does not move the air efficiently at all, and it'll hurt bottom end performance greatly, in which that engine application, we need that bottom end performance to get the vehicle motivated to move, because odds are it's not going to have a very large camshaft in it either. Whereas in stark comparison, if we went to like a 400 cubic inch displacement engine with that 12 to 1 compression, we'd probably be looking at a head somewhere in that 215, 220, 230 cc range, depending on what the max RPM potential of that combination was. So it's very important to evaluate the engine as a whole when selecting the right head. So if you need help selecting the right set of heads for your vehicle application, then go ahead and give us a call. There's just a few pieces of information we're going to need from you ahead of time. Main things are engine cubic inch displacement, the desired compression ratio, type of pistons that are in the engine, camshaft profile, and how the engine is mainly going to be used. Keep an eye out for part two in this series when we talk about cylinder head combustion chambers.